Developing vaccines is usually a very lengthy process, taking on average 8 years to get approved. Since a few years, we have the ability to create mRNA vaccines, which can be developed much faster. So how do these vaccines work? Are they safe? And how do they compare to traditional ones? But first, you must understand how the immune system works. When a virus enters your body, it will attach itself to one of your cells and inject its DNA or RNA into it. This is like a blueprint for your cells, containing instructions on what the cell has to make. So in this case, the virus's RNA will tell your cell to make more copies of the same virus. They become factories, assembling new copies of the virus that can infect even more cells. But don't worry, our bodies have a defense system for foreign intruders. The immune system attacks any protein, virus, or bacteria that does not belong in our bodies. But it takes a few days for it to learn how to attack the intruder. Meanwhile, the virus factories are running non-stop, quickly replicating the virus and spreading it in your body. In other words, you start experiencing symptoms of whatever has infected you. After a few days, however, your immune system will have figured out how to attack the virus and will start producing antibodies. These attach themselves to the virus, preventing them from infecting more cells and marking them for destruction. As you can see, the immune system is remarkable, but it's slow to mount an attack. That is the reason why we can get sick in the first place. So to give it a helping hand, we developed vaccines. The main idea is to train your immune system to recognize and fight off an infection before it has occurred. Almost like showing your immune system a mugshot of the virus and saying, "If you see this, kill it." There are various types of vaccines, but let's take a look at the new kit on the block, mRNA vaccines. To understand how they work, let's take the COVID-19 pandemic as an example. You might have seen pictures of the virus with its distinctive spikes. These spikes allow the virus to attach to specific cells in your body and infect them. Now, here's the key idea for the COVID-19 vaccine. What if we could train our immune system to recognize these spikes by having our own bodies produce them? To do that, researchers took the virus's blueprint, its RNA, and isolated the part responsible for producing the spikes. Armed with this blueprint, they created mRNA, or messenger RNA. This is a special form of RNA that can enter your cells and give them instructions. In this case, the RNA contains instructions to build the spikes of the coronavirus. Not the virus itself, just the spikes. So mRNA vaccines contain instructions for your cells that tell them to build a part of a virus in large volumes, almost like giving them a recipe to follow. Once this is happening, your immune system kicks into action and starts learning how to attack these intruders. Again, it takes some time for the immune system to fight off these spikes, but you won't get sick because it's only the spikes, not the virus itself. And that's it. Your immune system has learned how to attack the spikes of the coronavirus. It destroys all the spikes and even breaks down the mRNA vaccine itself. The only thing left in your body are special B cells or memory cells. These can linger around for months or years until the same virus infects you again. When that happens, the B cells can produce the correct antibodies right away, preventing the virus from spreading and making you sick. What's interesting about this mRNA technique is that it's relatively quick to develop a vaccine as soon as we know the DNA or RNA sequence of a virus. And secondly, because the vaccine only makes our bodies produce a tiny part of a virus, we cannot get sick from it. More traditional vaccines use weakened versions of the actual virus. This also triggers an immune response, but could also give you mild symptoms. Now you know how mRNA vaccines work. But don't take my word for it. All sources used to make this video are listed in the description below. Check it out if you want a more in-depth explanation. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it interesting and consider subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching, until next time.